Well, as we wind down for the year, what a year it's been in Green Mountain politics. We are reminded of the old adage, one decision can change everything. And so it did. On August 27th of this year, a decision that promises to reshape the political landscape in Vermont for years to come. We take a look at tonight's Year in Review segment.
It's been the great privilege of my life to serve the people of this state.
One morning last August, Governor Jim Douglas stunned much of his state, announcing that after nearly 40 years in office, he's had enough.
I will have held center stage long enough for any leader. I will not seek another term as governor of Vermont.
UVM political professor Garrison Nelson doesn't think there are any other Republicans moderate enough for Vermonters.
Douglas is the last of the sort of the Aiken, Stafford, Jeffords wing of the Republican Party in Vermont. You know, soft-spoken, social, liberal and moderates, you know, fiscal conservatives.
One possible candidate, Lieutenant Governor Brian Doobie.
And very soon I will share my decision about new opportunities that this announcement presents.
Soon, Brian Doobie confirmed he would seek the governorship. But the real story was what was happening on the other side.
You know, it's a real sign that Vermonters are looking for new leadership in Montpelier.
Democrats like Deb Markowitz, the Secretary of State, were running hard for governor. She raised a record $200,000, more than a year ahead of the election. State Senator Doug Racine was also a declared candidate and had money coming in. But the Douglas decision prompted many more to seize the opportunity.
I am totally committed to becoming the next governor of the state of Vermont. I will do it.
Senator Susan Bartlett of Lamoille County jumped in. So did a former senator, Matt Dunn of Windsor, as did the Senate president, Peter Shumlin of Windham County.
I will be a candidate for governor in 2010.
Making it a five-way battle for the Democrats for the right to challenge Doobie for the state's top job. The year also saw challengers emerge for veteran U.S. Senator Patrick Leahy. While his visits home in 2009 usually included doling out federal money, we also learned he'll face a challenge from both the left and the right in his bid for re-election. Declaring it a wake-up call to the state, two-term auditor Tom Salmon walked to the microphones and announced he's a Democrat no more.
I'm changing my political affiliation to align myself with a party more committed to the realities of our fiscal condition.
And 2009 also saw a bit of the unexpected. Tom Salmon defected from the Democrats and weeks later was back at the news pleading guilty to drunk driving. And there were bizarre stories surrounding State Senator Ed Flanagan, alleging inappropriate conduct in the men's room at the Burlington YMCA. Prosecutors declined to file charges, but even Democrats wondered how long Flanagan's political career could survive. The year saw titanic battles between the Democratic state legislature and the Republican governor, which Douglas frequently lost.
There's not perfect unanimity across the table in terms.
But his new chairmanship of the National Governors Association earned him repeated invitations to Washington and to the White House for talks with his new pal, President Obama. In politics, one decision can change everything. And so it did in 2009.
There's no doubt that over the past 7 years, we've accomplished much. We've seen this state through some tough times in our nation's history, and I'll continue to work day and night so that we emerge stronger than before. I'm so proud of what we've accomplished, and there will always be more to do. The work of democracy is an abiding, beautiful struggle, just as it should be.